Hi friends, today I'll discuss with the topic that is Markownikoff rule. And Anti-Markownikoff rule. It is also called as Kharasch effect. So here, let me explain the first one. So here, I'll take the simple molecule, that is it's an asymmetrical molecule. The name is propene. When it is made to react with any halo acids, especially hydrogen bromide, the product obtained here is the CH3 CHBr CH3. So the other possible product is but here the major product obtained here is the first one. The reason is because we know that it is an electrophilic addition reaction. The mechanism followed here is we know that the double bond is electron rich. It accepts the hydrogen from the halo acid to give the first is CH3CH CH2, it will become CH3, and the center carbon atom will carry the positive charge, that is carbocation. Next, once the bond shifts here, then Br minus will attack the carbon and we get the product, the first one. Whereas in the case of the anti-Markownikoff rule, the same molecule can show the other product in presence of the compound, that is peroxy compound. So here I take CH3CH1CH2HBr. Here I take peroxide compound. So the peroxides can be anything, hydrogen peroxide or benzoyl peroxide or any peroxide compounds. Here in the presence of the peroxide, it shows the other product. That means we get here the product CH2Br and CH2. So here it is a mechanism. Here the mechanism of the Kharasch effect or anti-Markownikoff rule is, we call this as a Markownikoff rule, and we can consider as an anti-Markownikoff rule, or it's also called as Kharasch effect. Here the mechanism, the first may be hydrogen peroxide or the benzoyl peroxide or any alkoxy peroxides also. When it is exposed to the light, either maybe heat or the sunlight, or it is showing the photosensitive effect. So due to that, the first, we call this as a initiation step. Initiation. Here, the free radical group, or the free radical will generate. Next, the propagation step, the propagation here, when the molecule that is taken here, CH3, CH double bond, CH2, here the free radical, will combine with the HBr. Before attaching into this, it will with the HBr here, the free radical generates like this. That means the formation of H2O plus Br with the free radical. Now bromine, or I'll write the same Br here, when the bromide radical is generated, so it will attack and it splits like this, and due to that the product can be obtained here is CH with the free radical and with CH2Br, and the resulted free radical will combine with the one more, the HBr molecule here. Due to the presence of the heat or light, the product can be obtained here is the bromide radical will attack the one more molecule, like that it continues, and it terminates the process which followed here. This is called as the termination process. But here some exception cases are there. The Markownikoff rule and Anti-Markownikoff rule is applicable for the hydrogen bromide or hydrobromic acid, but the same is not applicable to the hydrogen iodide and hydrochloric acid. So here if I take the same molecule, here I get the product even in presence of peroxide compound, but it obeys Markownikoff rule. So hence we get the product here is CH3, and here the Cl, and here also CH3Ci and CH3, and here also CH3. So the reason is because the exception case here observed is due to because the free radical mechanism which is followed in the first case, that means in the HCl, the enthalpy of the reaction, the propagation steps follows the first, shows first step is exothermic and the next step is endothermic, so which results the Markownikoff rule. And in the second one, the enthalpy of the second one here, the first step is endothermic and the second one, second step is exothermic. Hence, it cancels out the Kharasch effect and it favors the Markownikoff rule. But whereas in the case of the hydrobromic acid, both first step and second step are exothermic reaction, hence it favors the Markownikoff rule. So then what is the Markownikoff rule? So here we can see the nucleophile or electronegative atom, that means bromine, will attack the carbon atom which is having the lower number of hydrogen. So hence the product obtained, the secondary product, here we get the primary haloalkane products. I hope you have understood. Thanks for watching.